The studio is looking so nice this morning.
These are the tulips that Claire Mollick got me for my birthday. So beautiful. I like to start out the day by burning a little bit of incense. I did just meditate for 10 minutes and wrote in my journal and outlined what I wanted to get done for the day. So I think one of the most important facets of getting things done is to set intention. So when you live your life with intentionality, the universe responds to that because you're actually putting forth a very conscious effort and outlining all of the things that you want to do in this lifetime. All right, guys, hi. I'm going to check out Alice Neal at Zwirner. I'm really, really curious about this show here. So I'm looking online. It says it's a wide selection of paintings and significant works on paper by Alice Neal from 1900 to 1984. Now, Alice Neal is one of my favorite artists of all time. She's definitely in my top 10, if not my top 5. It says, with a range of works spanning her career, this exhibition will focus primarily on Neal's portrayal of the nude figure and will demonstrate how the artist resolutely challenged traditional perceptions of sexuality. So getting the fuck out of here and... yeah, I'll take some pictures and see you there. Bye. Guys, check it out. It's a gorgeous day in the neighborhood. I live right here at 17th and Cortelyou in Ditmas Park. And the sun is shining today. So, super glad to be out. I painted for a couple hours and worked on some other stuff this morning. Oh, I worked on my workshop at the Art Students League. It's Monday through Wednesday next week. So I'm getting everything squared away for that. We have 3 people signed up so far. Yay! Check this out. Outfit of the day, classic. Just black jeans, black shoes, and you know, this beautiful velour jacket that I always wear. I'm going to the painting center. How about you?
Gonna make a change.
I'm not gonna keep saying that. So where do you want to go?
Night going out to, I think I made it to like 6 or 7 openings. Yeah, probably about 6. Ran into a few friends and you know, it was just overall a great night. I just want to share this beautiful image of New York at night, and you know, sometimes it's so nice just to walk without headphones to really hear the sounds of the city. It's one of the best, most greatest reasons why I'm living here is just the energy, the frenetic energy of the city. So beautiful, guys. Up here in Chelsea. I spend so much of my time up here, and look at that. Oh, hey guys, how you doing? What up?
It is currently Friday. It's about noon. Wearing my I Love Cambodia shirt. Oh, yeah. And my gorgeous pajama pants. I just wanted to hang out with you guys because I'm in a pretty social mood right now, and I'm about to paint, so of course I'm always in a great mood right before I'm about to paint. I hope everyone's doing awesome today. I hope you're enjoying your, I hope you actually had a really good week and you're enjoying your Friday. I also hope that you're not one of those people that looks forward to Friday the most just because it's the weekend. Because I really want you to love your job, and I think that's really important for the overall quality and health of yourself and quality of life. If you go into work, you know, 5 days a week for 8 hours a day, 40 hours a week, and you don't like your job, that's a lot, that's a hell of a lot of time. So I hope that you're enjoying your Friday, not just because it's Friday, but just because it's another day that you're alive. I actually don't really differentiate too much between the weekend and the work week, because I actually work on the weekends as well, and so does Blair. He actually goes to his woodworking studio, and I'll stay here and paint. So do you guys want a sneak peek of my new painting? All right, well, it's right here in front of me. I'm looking at it, and she is a beauty. All right, so the title of this piece is called James, or Mommy Ruined XXXmas. So I don't wanna show too much of this, but I will show just a little bit. So I've been working on the entire background, and then of course I will go in with one other layer on top of the entirety of the flesh tones. And I'm loving this woodwork here. I actually haven't painted a wooden floor since this painting. And this painting was actually painted in 2008 after a breakup. But that is the last time I painted a wood floor, I think. No, wait, there might have been one other time with a dead rabbit painting. It was kind of funny last night because I met this girl and she really connected with my dead rabbit painting. I have a slew of business cards and I just kind of let people pick whichever card that they feel suits them. And she pulled the dead rabbit right away. I was just like, why do you connect with this dead rabbit? And her dog had gotten caught by a coyote and she went out to rescue the dog, and the dog just out of fear bit the coyote somehow, and so the coyote dropped him, the dog ran away, and then in its place very shortly thereafter there was a dead rabbit right where the coyote almost killed the dog. So this girl really had a connection with my dead rabbit piece. I know I'm rambling, but I'm just in such a great mood, you guys. I don't know, I feel like spring's here, and I feel like, all right, so I'll be honest. I think that I had a candida infection in my, or a systemic candida, infection would be the word, in my body. And I've recently been treating this and cutting out more breads and more sugar. So I still am eating dark chocolate every night, but I feel like this veil has been lifted, and I'm a little bit concerned because I feel like for the past year and a half, 2 years, I may or may not have had this candida affliction. So I'm just sorting through that, but I feel really freaking good. And I'm like, no, I'm not on any drugs, just the usual coffee. But I don't know, I feel really good. So I was in the gym this morning training my private client, and I walked past this guy, and I didn't want to make an assumption of where he was from. And I was getting the weights and I was getting us set up and everything. And I walked past him again, and he goes, and he does this full double take. And he saw my shirt. And he was like, hey, you've gone to Cambodia? Tell me your connection. And turns out he actually used to live in Phnom Penh, and he actually owns land in Siem Reap, which really flipped my world, because this is 8:30 in the morning and I have been working on this vision board of having a wooden house in Siem Reap in the future. And so I was like, you own land in Siem Reap? Do you have a house? Do you need me to watch your house? Like, I literally said that to him. And he's like, I actually just have the land in Siem Reap, and I don't really have the house, but I think he does
have like a house in Phnom Penh or something like that. But we chatted for like 5 minutes and it was such a cool connection. I was like, Sus Thai, Suk Sabai. And he just, I don't know, we just shared this Cambodian connection at like 8:30 in the morning, and what a blessed day. I don't know. And I just feel like any time that those kinds of things happen, I feel like it's because I'm putting my energy out there in the universe. And I feel like the strongest part of putting that energy out there in the universe is intention. So for instance, I've been working on my vision board, and I actually wrote in my diary about a very specific wooden house. It's an A-frame house. I see it in my mind. There's two floors. The top floor is like an open floor. And I actually talked about this in a former video. So this is out there and it's happening, and I haven't really seen the house yet, but it will happen. So I'm putting these things out there in the universe, and I feel like the energy of the universe responds to that. And these little things that I see around me aren't just coincidences. Otherwise, it's so freaking strange, and we live in a very strange world. Like, for instance, this morning I thought of the word ask, and I remember that Amanda Palmer had written this book. I think she wrote a book about it, about asking, just simply the art of asking. But it was years ago that I even came across Amanda Palmer talking about this concept of simply asking, and how people are very afraid to ask. And I'm just walking up in Williamsburg this morning, and I see this sign for Amanda Palmer, and I'm like, what the hell? So anyway, I mean, little things like that that just kind of come up, and that you might be able to brush off as coincidence if it just happens once or twice, but this happens so frequently that I don't even question it anymore. I'm not really freaked out by it. I'm just like, okay, I'm definitely on the right path, and I see you. I read you as a sign, and I brought you to me through energy, and we came to each other through energy. Anyway, I had a lot of fun last night. I hope you guys enjoyed the very brief footage that I did take. I love going out on my own, and for several reasons. One, it makes me feel really independent, and I can pretty much break away and leave the crowd whenever I want. I can take as much time or as little time with the artworks that I want. But second, and probably more importantly, I actually meet people. So I really make it a point to leave my energy open and vulnerable, and ready to engage in conversation in case someone kind of comes around. And I love that. I love meeting new people. My goal last night was to hand out 10 business cards. So I went into the night with this intention. I'm gonna hand out 10 business cards. I'm gonna make 10 connections. I did not reach the 10, but I think I reached 4 or 5, which is pretty good. So, and they were good connections. They were like, you know, not just like, here's my card, you know. I am getting set up to paint, just opening my palette. I use the Masterson Covered palette, and actually, woo, when I open it, it smells so strong of that oil paint, because it's just been marinating in there all night. But the Masterson Covered palette keeps the paints really wet for at least a good 2 days. It's been nice saying hello to you, so thank you so much for listening, and thank you so much for watching. I believe this is the 30-something episode of A Painter's Vlog. If you guys have any questions, please leave them below, and thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, even though I'm just kind of ranting today, please give a like and subscribe, and follow me on my journey as a painter here in Brooklyn and beyond, of course, Cambodia. So thank you guys so much. Love you. Brooklyn squirrel. Look at this. What's he eating, babe?
I don't know.
No. Looks like a honeycomb.
No.
Oh my god, I think it's a ramen.
It's ramen?